There's a printer on Richmond called VCI, and the contact name there is Mike Harris. They do a lot of different kind of printing. Like they do, they print on vinyl, they do like large signs, they can print on plastic, they can print on metal. They have all kinds of innovative ways of printing. They don't do offset printing, but they have digital printing, they have letterpress printing. So anything weird that you think you need to print on, like, you know, you have to, I don't know, print on a mailbox or something, call Mike. I mean, he'll figure out a way to do it.
So what's a good way to get started? I mean, I'm in a gray area where I'm a good designer, but, you know, people want experience. I am volunteering to do a logo for our church that doesn't have a budget for advertising.
Yeah.
But, I mean, they already have their own ideas and colors, so it's hard to,
well,
but I want to get something out there.
Right. Well, I'll tell you what, you know, it's 2010, and things are a lot different now. When I was in college, the internet was not as prevalent as it is now. So I had to like do the legwork and the mouth work to get myself noticed and get work, okay? Now you have the internet, and there's sites like sologig.com and elance.com. There's also Craigslist. I mean, post yourself out there, like, you know, I'm a graphic designer willing to do work for, I'll do your logo for $50.
What was the one you said before, Craigslist?
Elance and Sologig.
Elance. Okay.
Elance.com and Sologig. And I actually think this guy, CrowdSpring, I think this guy does the same thing on his site from when I'm reading his bio.
Yeah.
Yes.
There's a group in Houston that I recently, that I'm going to be networking with. They're called the Creative Group. They are free staffing for freelance projects as well as permanent hire.
Let me give you some insight on that before we get any further. They are a staffing firm, just like Aquin is, just like Art Squad is. The problem with these three companies or these staffing firms is that you have to have a minimum of 5 to 10 years before they'll staff you. Okay? You have to have a significant portfolio before they'll spend time on you. They'll meet with you, they'll tell you, oh yeah, I'm going to get you some work. Oh yeah, you've got great stuff. They're not going to spend their time on you because you don't have the experience. And they get paid by getting you hired. If you don't have the qualifications to get into a, you know, Fortune 500 company, they're not gonna spend time on you. Now, 5 years from now, after you've been doing this for 5 years and you have a significant portfolio, they go to the creative group and have them help you find a job. But right now, that is not, I don't think that's a very good option.
Once they own you, once.
Once they own you?
They do, I mean,
well, then, you know,
if you got hired for the company you were, you know, like Aquin, then the company has to pay them an awful lot of money before
right.
they let you go to them.
Yeah, they get a commission. I mean, they're selling, you're basically their product. You know, you're like the tissue box on the shelf. They're going to sell you, you know, above Kleenex because you have softer skin, you know? So if you don't have those qualifications, they're not going to put you on the shelf. So just keep that in mind. You know, for in the beginning, that's not a good option.
No.
In the future, it is. Yes.
Now I've seen for startup designers, a lot of them when they do work, they don't charge a lot, but they include their website on the print work. So it's free marketing. So if somebody gets a brochure, flyer, whatever it is, they look at it and they can go visit your portfolio online. So
and
would
also,
you recommend that if you're going to do something inexpensive, put that on your contract and say, you know, I'm not going to charge you as much, but my information, my web page is going to be printed on here, designed by such and such.
Yes, that's a very good point. You definitely want, if you're not going to be paid as much money, then use them as an advertising tool. Make sure that they're okay with you putting your name and your website on their piece. You can even put your copyright information. You can put copyright Susanna Armstrong 2010 and your website on there, as long as they agree to it, okay? If they agree to it, yes, that's a great way to get yourself, you know, your name out there and your skills known, okay? But I think online sites to do freelance, promoting yourself on Craigslist, word of mouth, I mean, the more you tell people, I can't tell you how much work I've gotten just by telling people I'm a graphic designer.
Networking.
Yes.
Would you suggest a contract for consulting? I'm seeing this, like, if you, like, I'm just getting started, I'm getting out there, getting my name around, but if they don't exactly know what they want, especially with a web design, they don't want to have, they don't have the money to pay for a website, and they have these sites called Wix.com or the other one I saw on TV that go on and set up their own site for their company, but I go through and try to talk her through it.
Okay, so you're not actually doing the work, but you're consulting her on how to do it?
Yeah.
That would still require an agreement. I would still give them an agreement. Of course, it's going to be highly modified because you're not doing as much of this work, but you still don't want to sell yourself short, and it's still your time. So you want to indicate how much are you willing to do for them. You're willing to do research for them. You're willing to spend 5 hours a week of your time available for her for any questions that she has. You're going to spend, you know, maybe 2 hours a day helping her figure out how to do something. So think about how you want to make yourself available to her to consult her, and put those terms down on the paper. Okay. Because again, you don't want to say, I'll help you for, you know, $200. And next thing you know, she's calling you in the middle of the night because she needs, you know, she needs a question answered. So be specific. I'm available for you on Saturdays from 10 to 2. I'm available for you, you know, 5 hours a week between 3 and 7 in the evening. You know, be very specific on your availability to that client.
Okay.
Okay?
Okay. But is there like consulting fees or a schedule? Have you had to do something like that?
Well, yeah, definitely. You definitely want to charge a consulting fee. I mean, because you're spending your time on her project. So you want to charge, you know, maybe you have, you set up that schedule 3 to 7, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and so many times on the weekends, is gonna be $200 a week. Mm-hmm. Anything more than that would be an extra $50.
Oh, okay. Okay. Well, it hasn't been that long, it's just a couple of times.
Yeah,
so she's been able to do a lot, so.
Yeah, just indicate how much time you're gonna be available for, how much she wants to pay for it, how much you want to charge her if she goes over that time, and that it's a minimum. So if she doesn't call you, say you're making yourself available to her 5 hours a week, and she doesn't call you but 1 hour, she's not going to get your money back. You know, she's not going to say, well, I only called you once this week, so I want $200 back. No, this is what we agreed upon. If you don't want to call me that whole time, that's fine, but I was still available for you, so you still have to pay me, and that's the minimum. Okay. You had a question?
Good at, like, getting yourself out there. Like, go to websites like GigaPoster or Threadless. Mm-hmm. Like, Threadless in particular, like, if you get a t-shirt design, if your t-shirt design gets picked, they give you $500. If you get a t-shirt of the year, $20,000.
Oh, that's good. You can also enter a lot of contests. You know, like, these clubs that we were talking about earlier, the Houston Ad Federation, the Houston Art Directors Club, sometimes these printing groups, there's always contests going on online. Some of the print magazines or web magazines, they have contests going on all the time. Always submit your stuff, because you never know when you're going to win. And if you do win, you get free advertising because your name is put out there publicly and your work is put out there publicly.
Okay, if you put it out publicly, should you go through the effort of legally copyrighting?
Yeah.
Okay.
I mean, I would. If it's really nice work.
Stolen from me.
Yeah, I mean, if it's work that you spend a lot of time on and you really are proud of that work, by all means, I would copyright it. You don't want someone else taking that idea. Okay. Pablo?
I was going to ask you, how do you bring up the contract without scaring your client or, you know?
Well, you know.
How do you set up the, you know, this is the way I work, so they take you seriously?
Right.
Because I know,
well, you know what?
There's a lot of young people here. And I know sometimes you'll meet a client, like, oh, these people, you know, they're not going to be that organized, they're not going to have a contract. You know, how do you make them take you seriously?
Well, if they don't take you seriously, that means that they're not serious about it. So when you meet with them and you get all your information and you say, okay, this is great, I'm going to give you an estimate to review it. And then once you approve it, you know, we'll put everything in writing and we'll both sign it so that we're both covered on our agreements. You can bring it around that way instead of actually saying, I'm signing a legal document here and you must sign it or I will come after you with the police and sue you. You know, you don't want to sound harsh, but you want to state the fact that you're going to have an agreement, you're going to put it on paper, and then please, I would like for you to sign it. And you can indicate that this is for your tax purposes, and they'll be more likely to sign it when they realize that you're a freelance contractor and you need this information for tax purposes. They're going to need it too, if they're smart. On the other hand, you know, if they freak out and they don't want to sign a contract, then you don't want to work with them because they probably weren't going to pay you in the beginning anyway. Okay.
Liz, can you post some of those sites you're talking about? I mean, email us, like,
Guru.com is another one. Guru.com is another freelance site.
Behance is a creative portfolio place where you can go and like, it's like Flickr but more professional. Retouch Creative. And they also have, they recently launched a site called The99%, and it's about being productive and making ideas happen. I mentioned that last time. Copy
me an email.
She said beehives, but that sounded like you're doing too, like cool things.
Like I said, like I just spoke at the Denver convention. I was able to meet and speak with the founder of Behance.
Oh wow!
Yeah, and he has a book out. It's called Making Ideas Happen.
Good.
So you guys should check that out.
That's awesome.
It's very inspiring.
Check it out sometime.
All right. Any other questions about what we've discussed today? Or anything? Okay, let me give you guys my email address. I'm sorry? Oh, you have one more?
Yeah, okay. I have one. This might be in there, but how many edits do you normally do with a client? Because I've gotten screwed over where I counted it because I went through emails about 25 edits.
Oh, the project that I told you, we had 45 edits. 45 rounds of edits. Towards the end, I wasn't even charging them per edit anymore. I was just charging them per day because they were having so many edits. There's really no way to avoid having a lot of edits because it's really the client's issue. You know, some clients have issues.
Yeah.
So the best way to cover yourself is to put it in the contract, you know, and let them know. I'm going to give you 3 concepts to start. I'm going to give you 2 drafts for you to review and make edits. This is how we're going to handle the edits, and you will pay me for the edits, and this is how you will pay me. If you go over this amount of edits, you will be charged X number of dollars. That is a good way to avoid it. Because once they see that it's going to cost so much money, they're not going to want to do that many edits. And they're going to make sure to have as many eyes look over that first draft before